My name is Georgia, and today I will be making blueberry muffins. I have a special guest, Ella. Hi. The ingredients you will need are
flour, baking powder, baking soda, and salt mixed together, sugar,
butter, egg, yogurt, a little extra sugar and flour, and I'll explain more about that later, some lemon zest, coarse sugar, and blueberries.
We have preheated the oven to 375 Fahrenheit, and we have also coated the baking pan with cooking spray.
Alternatively, you can use cupcake liners in your pan if you like that, but I preferably don't like that as much. So the reason that we have set aside extra flour and sugar is so that our blueberries don't sink to the bottom of our muffins. I have 1 tablespoon of each, and I have here 1 1/4 cups to 1 1/2 cups of blueberries, and I'm just going to mix it in with our flour and sugar mix. Mix this onto our blueberries.
I'm going to set this aside, and now we are going to melt the butter.
While Ella's taking a snack break, I have melted my butter, this is 5 tablespoons of it, and now I'm going to spoon out 1 cup of yogurt. Make that 3/4 of a cup of yogurt. My dad made the yogurt. He wanted me to say that. I needed another jar of yogurt because I only got to not even 1/2 cup. While Ella is finishing up, I am going to mix my dry ingredients, which is, as Ella said, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, and 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking powder, and also 1 1/2 cups of flour, which is equal to 195 grams of flour. Ella's finally gotten some food in her, and now we're going to mix our wet ingredients. One egg, 3/4 cup of yogurt, 1/2 cup of sugar, which is equivalent to 100 grams, and 5 tablespoons of butter, and about 1/2 lemon of zest. There. Just pour it in. That's 5 tablespoons.
Now we've switched from a spatula to a whisk because it's easier.
And we're going to fold our dry ingredients into our wet ingredients. I'm adding my dry ingredients into my wet ingredients. You can do it in sections, but I find it's just as fine. It works just as well to do it all in one. As long as you fold it and don't overmix. It's almost fully mixed, but there's still some dry ingredients that you can see. But you don't want to fully mix it before your blueberries go in, because then you might overmix it because you still need to mix it with blueberries. Ella, do you want to do the honors?
Of course.
You just want to fold your blueberries in. We're using frozen, but you can always use fresh. Those work too. It's not the season.
Now we are going to use
the ice cream scoop. Put it in. Yeah.
This is weird.
Okay.
Now we have put all of our batter into the pan.
Yeah.
So now we will sprinkle a little bit of the brown sugar.
It's coarse sugar. Just like, correction, not brown.
It looks like
I mean,
sugar.
It is brown sugar, but Just a little bit on each. Oops. Just a little. We switched to doing it with our fingers since we thought it would be a little easier.
And it is. So we recommend that you switch to fingers too. We have finished coating our muffins with the sugar.
And we're going to put them into our preheated oven for about 25 minutes. Depending on your oven, you might need a little more or a little less. We finished baking our muffins for about 28 minutes, and we let them cool in the pan for a little while, then put them out onto a bit, onto a cooling rack, and now we're going to taste them.
The muffins were great, and please subscribe. Thank you.